The year is 1978, and the home gaming industry is just starting to emerge. At this point, the world of programming, game development in particular, is still completely dominated by men. That is, until a trailblazing pioneer comes along, shattering existing norms and preconceived notions. By creating hit game after hit game, she helps pave the way for women to enter the field of game development. In this video, we talk about Carol Shaw, one of the first women to ever work in game development and programming. My name's Liv. Let's talk about her. Carol Shaw was born in 1955 in Palo Alto, California. Shaw showed an early interest in machines, often playing and tinkering with her brother's train sets. Being a Stanford Lab mechanical engineer, her father was understandably thrilled by his daughter's interests and actively encouraged her. With her parents' encouragement, Shaw focused on mathematics and excelled at it. Throughout middle school and high school, Shaw entered a myriad of math competitions and took home a ton of trophies. Shaw's first experience using a computer was in a high school math class. The course had her write short programs to perform math calculations, but Shaw was reportedly intimidated by the overwhelming majority of her classmates being boys. Nevertheless, she persevered through the course and continued to excel in her mathematical education. After high school, she went on to attend UC Berkeley. She started in the College of Letters and Science, but soon transferred to Berkeley's College of Engineering after she took a programming course on Fortran and discovered the electrical engineering and computer science major. She graduated with a bachelor's degree in 1977, and only a year after obtained a master's degree in computer science. As Shaw was finishing up her final master's papers, she received a job offer from Atari. She happily accepted, as the idea of being able to play games at work was too good to pass up. Up to this point, she had never even attempted to program a game, but she was fond of playing arcade games and had more than enough related programming experience to qualify. Shaw started as the only woman working in her division at Atari, but she was used to it since most of her college classes were the same way. As a microprocessor software engineer, she developed a wide collection of games for Atari's popular new computer system, including 3D tic-tac-toe, video checkers, and Othello. After a couple years of developing games, Shaw decided to try out something new and worked for Tandem, where she worked with assembly language programming. Less than 2 years into working there, a new gaming company founded by her old Atari coworkers made her a job offer. In 1981, Shaw started working at a small new company named Activision on the game that would become her claim to fame, River Raid. With the success of River Raid, along with later work with Tandem, Shaw was able to save up and retire early in 1990. In retirement, Shaw volunteered with Foresight Institute, a nonprofit that promotes nanotech technology development. More recently, Shaw received the Industry Icon Award at the Game Awards in 2017. Shaw now spends her time happily in retirement with her husband, Ralph Merkel, in Northern California. Because of Shaw's success, game development is no longer seen as a men's only club. But we still have quite a way to go before women have a truly equal share in it. As of 2017, less than 30% of computer programmers are female. But because of Shaw and other pioneers, the situation dramatically shifted. No longer was the game industry just for the boys. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more content like this. See you in the next one.